is our YouTube. This is Andy here from The Fragment, but it's still not with us at the minute. But I thought I'd crack on and get another one out of the way. So this fragrance that I'm about to do a review on, I've got a few of their colognes, Eau de Toilette's. Really good house, very sophisticated. And this one, I think, will probably be a classic. And it is, of course, Gucci Buron 2. As you can see, the box, the box, very nice, very slick, and there is all your bar information down there. This was released in 2007. I have smelt the original. This one is, I would say, more brighter, more playful than the original. And there's the bottle. As you can see, it's almost empty. I think I have a literally like a drop left. But I love this stuff, and there's a reason there's a drop left. It's because I use it a lot. As you can see, that it's almost like a wood design there, very slick, but it's metal. And again, same color on the sprayer. As I said, you get your numbers on the bottom there to match the box. Okay, so I will get into the pitfalls, and there are pitfalls of this one, and I know some of you who maybe own this one or any of the other Gucci line will know where I'm going with that. But let's get into the notes and all the rest of it first. So the top notes, we got bergamot, violet leaf. Mids, we got black tea and cinnamon. And the base notes, we have tobacco leaves, musk, and olive wood. It smells like black tea, like a sweet black tea. I definitely get some violet there, a little bit of cinnamon, a little bit of bergamot, but it smells like black tea. Very sweet. A few words to sum this up: playful, warm and spicy, but it's definitely complex, I think. I think so anyway. There's really nothing like it on the market that I can think of, or nothing that comes close to this. You know, I can rattle off a few names of colognes that smell like other ones that I have, but this one kind of stands on its own. I know a lot of people wear this, and I think it's going to be a classic in their line, because it's definitely a good fragrance. I like it. It smells amazing. Okay, so the pitfalls. This one has one big one, along with all the other Gucci ones, like Gucci by Gucci and all the other ones that I have. There's longevity. And the life in general of the fragrance is not great. I get about 2 hours, 2.5 hours total, the whole thing, from top to bottom, from the dry down, from the initial spray, everything. Some people I know get 6 hours, so it really just depends on your own skin. The best thing to do is when you go to the vendor to get your colognes, or if you buy, well, certainly wouldn't buy this one online, but spray it first and come back and get it. Now, when I first started buying colognes, when I first get into the cologne game, if it smelled nice, I'd buy it there and then. Just, you sold me when I first sprayed it. And then I'd take it home, and 2 or 3 hours later it was gone, and it was a complete waste of money. And that kind of annoyed me. But this one, as I said, there's a reason that most of this is gone. It's because I love it. And I can put it back on, respray it. It's very inoffensive, and it's not going to completely cloud everyone. And there are ways to bring a cologne back to life again. For me, if I nip off to the restroom or to the sink, splash a teeny bit of water on my chest or my arms or wherever I've actually sprayed it, that tends to bring the fragrance back out. It only lasts for another 20 minutes or so, but I get a bit more life out of it. Okay, so price ranges. $30 up. That's pretty much what I have. It depends where you shop. You can go online, get a better deal, what have you. Again, I would spray this first, give it a test, or see if you like it. Age range, anyone, high school, college, upwards. It has a mature side to it, but it also has this playful, sweet side, which will certainly be more drawn towards the younger crowd. So again, life, not great, but it's an amazing fragrance. It's definitely, for me, worth the money. Any age range, Summer and spring, I would definitely say, would be the seasons to wear this in. But you could wear it in winter. But I definitely think because of the playfulness of it and the spiciness, it's got a warm spiciness to it as well. I would definitely say this is probably more for summer and for spring. So that's my review on Gucci Per Homme 2. Definitely try this, guys. See what you think of it. It's an amazing smelling fragrance. But as I said, it does have its pitfalls. But they're worth it if you like the smell. So I'm Andy for the Fragmen. Peace.